We've got politicians reading the Bible to us. The USCCB General Secretary resigns, but the witch hunt continues, as does the drama over the Latin Mass. And Big Papa celebrates Old People Day. Let's go, old people. First off, we have this incredible excerpt from the Bible from our beloved Vice President.
The very essence of what the Bible tells us when it says, love thy neighbor. And in the face of that stranger, you see a friend.
I'm sorry, what verse was that again? I'm pretty well educated. I've been listening to Bible in a year for at least a month. I'm catching up.
That's what this is about. And so by getting vaccinated, you are loving your neighbor.
Checkmate, Christians. Check yourself. She sounds like someone who doesn't really know what they're talking about. It's kind of like when someone says, it's scientifically proven, actually. Who said that? scientists. Which scientists? Well, I mean, I maybe haven't read actually an article about it, but I saw a headline at the bottom of a website. It said it was science. Honestly, though, it's clear she's trying to use sacred scripture for politics, and regardless of what you think about being vaccinated, it's pretty disrespectful and even kind of sick to use sacred scripture in that way. Nancy Pelosi seems to be having a similar problem and calls on her Catholic faith to justify her support of abortion.
As a devout Catholic and mother of 5 and 6 years, I feel that God blessed my husband and me with our beautiful family. And it's an issue of fairness and justice for poor women in our country.
Fairness? How about fairness to the baby being aborted? Where's your support for his or her health? Where's the justice for the baby's dying? Pelosi's own Archbishop Salvatore Cordileone courageously wrote a strong statement on Friday saying, "Let me repeat, no one can claim to be a devout Catholic and condone the killing of innocent human life, let alone have the government pay for it. To use the smokescreen of abortion as an issue of health and fairness to poor women is the epitome of hypocrisy. What about the health of the baby being killed? What about giving poor women real choice so they are supported in choosing life? This would give them fairness and equality to women of means who can afford to bring a child into the world. Thank you, Archbishop. Let's pray for him." And Nancy and Kamala. Monsignor Jeffrey Burrill has resigned as the USCCB General Secretary after sexual misconduct allegations. Not illegal actions, but just actions that are inappropriate. And as I predicted, the witch hunt continues. They found proof of this misconduct using anonymous app data. I've done a deep dive on this topic because the implications of this are huge. You can check out that whole video right here or there or somewhere around there. After these allegations surfaced, he resigned immediately. The conference takes all allegations of misconduct seriously and will pursue all appropriate steps to address them, said Archbishop Gomez. I ask for your prayers for Monsignor and for the conference staff during this difficult time. And I would agree. Let's please pray for the USCCB staff and Monsignor. Regardless, the app tracking continues. The pillar who first discovered this data has continued to review more data and has found more evidence of more apps being used in more locations by more people. Okay, the Latin Mass. To be brief, bishops around the world have slowly been responding and issuing guidance for their dioceses. For the most part, just allowing churches to continue to celebrate the Latin Mass as they were before. Meanwhile, Cardinal Mueller, Cardinal Burke, and Cardinal Casper have each responded strongly in different ways. Cardinal Mueller says that Pope Francis has failed to adequately make his case in restricting the Latin Mass, saying that instead of appreciating the smell of the sheep, the shepherd here hits them hard with his crook. That's pretty strong language. Cardinal Burke questions whether Pope Francis even has the authority to revoke the use of the old rite. And Cardinal Casper says in an interview with the National Catholic Register that he believes the overwhelming majority of Catholic faithful are firmly against the traditional Latin Mass, and that some of its adherents scandalize them by believing it's the only true Catholic Mass and rejecting the Second Vatican Council more or less in its entirety. And that is also very strong. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Is the Latin Mass divisive or not? In Canada, last week, another church has burnt to the ground, this one being a Coptic Orthodox church. Now, the Coptics are not in union with the Pope, but they do have a very long history going back to St. Mark. But not the Canadian residential schools, which means that this arson attack was pretty stupid. I mean, it was already super stupid, but now it's even more super stupid. Super duper stupid. I guess arsons aren't really known for being too rational, but here's what the bishop said. While today is a day of sadness, we will not be deterred and we will rebuild. Our church will always be open for all and continue to be a beacon of light and hope for all in our community. Let us pray for the Coptic Christians. Big Papa celebrates the first World Day for grandparents and the elderly with Mass and reminds us that elderly are not leftovers from life, and urged young Catholics to visit their grandparents, their elderly relatives, and the older people in their neighborhood. They protected us as we grew, and now it is up to us to protect their lives, to alleviate their difficulties, to attend to their needs, and to ensure that they are helped in daily life and not feel alone. May we never regret that we were insufficiently attentive to those who loved us and gave us life. Text your grandma and tell her you love her. What are you, a chicken? I guess I should text my grandma. Hey Grammy, love you, miss you. Hope you're well. We're good. The saints for this week are literally Jesus's grandparents. Yeah, he had grandparents. Saints Joachim and Anne. Or is it Joachim, Joachim, I don't really know. To be honest, not a lot is known about them except that they existed and they were Mary's parents. Therefore, Jesus's grandparents. They are the patron saints of grandparents, mothers, and women in labor. Saints Joachim and Anne, please pray for us. I'm sure I messed up a whole bunch of things this week, so be sure to check the description for corrections, and we will see you next week. Bless you.
Did you see the shirt my wife got me? Oh, yeah.